Hey parents, I wanted to make a quick video rather than sending long texts. I'll probably end up summarizing it in the text anyway. But for you guys, just to check in with you guys, a lot has been going on with distance learning and the way they rolled it out. I feel like we were waiting for information and then boom, all this information came to the teachers that we had to pass on to you guys. And I'm still learning it myself. It's been a very big learning curve for me. I have four kids of my own. I'm trying to juggle what they're doing in their four schedules. I'm doing this at night. I stay up after bedtime and get all these videos uploaded and made and then ready for you guys in the morning. My hope is that that made it easier rather than trying to do live sessions. That way they can, you guys, whatever schedule you have, you just start the videos. I've had a great suggestion from Ileana's mom that we're going to try this week. And if it doesn't work out, let me know. I can go back to the other format. But rather than having, half a dozen to a dozen videos each day, I'm going to condense all of one subject's videos into one video. So you'll have one long video for language arts, like 20 to 30 minutes long, but they can pause and restart it as they go. That way they don't have to keep switching between screens, because I know for some of them it's tricky to minimize, get into the email, click the next link. So maybe that'll be a little easier for them. And you only have to do that, calendar, language arts, math, and then if there's any extra things going on. There is two for math because the number talks, I usually do them at a different time because of the responses I get from the kids. So if you guys have other suggestions, please, please tell me. I want to make this easier for you and for your families. There's already enough crazy going on. I don't want it to be something that's harder. School's been harder for me with my kids, so I'm trying to think of like if I could have it my way, what would I want as a parent? And having the ability to set my own schedule would be golden. So if you have other suggestions, please send them in. Also, attendance. I'm not taking it every day. The district is requiring us to report if we haven't heard from a family within 48 hours. So every 2 days, guys, I need to hear from you, whether it be an email or your teacher kid to send me an email. Hi, Mrs. McMahon, did my math. Hi, Mrs. McMahon, did my language arts. Just tell me that you're working on something, and that will count. If I don't hear from you, I'll try to reach out to you first and give you a few more hours, and then I gotta report it, and then they're gonna start calling you from the school saying, "Hey, Mrs. McMahon says she hasn't heard from you," et cetera, et cetera. And I don't wanna have to put you guys, there's enough going on. So if you could just, hey, every couple days, or have your kid when they're in that Microsoft Teams, whatever, send me a chat, that counts too. As long as we're connecting, it counts. Those chats will keep happening Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 11:15 a.m. I'll be there. It's recess time. It's just for fun. It's a chance for me to see them, for them to see me. It counts for attendance. Great. Some of you have been really participating in the number talks. I love it. I love it. When you send your vi videos of the kids and pictures of the kids, that's fantastic. And I'm sure they like seeing themselves in the videos. Those ones are always unlisted on YouTube, so strangers won't find them, only people with links to the videos. So you can be, feel good about that. But you don't have to do that. That's just for fun. So if it's something that you have time to do, great. If you don't, no worries. I'll still do the number talks every day with the kiddos. Also, I know for some people it's a lot to turn things in every day. Don't worry about it. On Friday, I'll send you a list and just get it to me by Sunday. And I'll make sure that I have the work. That's just to help me know that they're meeting the standards and that they're getting ready for second grade. So on Friday, I'll send probably 3 to 5 assignments that I would like to have a picture taken of and just email it over. Or you can teach your kiddo how to do that. So I hope this covered everything. I hope things are going okay for all of you. This is so strange. I miss the kids so much. The last video we did when I got to see them on there and I got tours of some of the homes. Oh, I got off the call and literally cried. I miss their hugs, their smiles. They make me laugh every day. So anyway, if you guys need anything, please, and please help me out. I'm seriously feel sometimes I'm like, oh, what am I doing? The magic of teaching is being there for the kiddos and being with them. And so this feels so different and so strange. And any help you guys can give me that will make it easier for them would help me be better at this now. I'll take it. So email me those suggestions and hope everything's going okay and keep checking in. And we're getting there. We're doing it. All right. So thanks, guys, for all you do.